Hi everyone, this is Margarita from ZigiWave, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate our ZigiOps platform and integration between Azure DevOps and ServiceNow. Let's log into the ZigiOps UI, where we will see the dashboard page with some basic information about the configurations. First, we can check the system health for both systems, ServiceNow and Azure DevOps, and test the connections. After we confirm the OK status of both systems, we go to the Configurator menu to review our configuration. We have configured System 1 to be Azure DevOps and System 2, the destination system, to be ServiceNow. For each system, we can dynamically select entity that we want to integrate. For Azure DevOps, you can choose from different projects discovered by ZigiOps. Similarly, in ServiceNow, you can dynamically choose from different tables depending on your requirements. Next, we have a list of operations, which are the actual actions that are going to achieve our use case. In this example, we want to create a new incident from Azure DevOps that will be updated in ServiceNow, and when there are changes in ServiceNow, we want to be able to see them in Azure DevOps. In the correlation menu, we define the logic of how ZigiOps will synchronize and keep both entities updated in both systems once the initial transfer is completed. In our example, we are storing the Azure DevOps system ID into the ServiceNow correlation ID. And we are storing the ServiceNow incident number into the Azure description field. Here we also have dynamic field selection if you want to choose any other fields, including custom fields for both systems. Now let's select an operation and see what options we have for it. First, we have action type that can be create, update, delete, or fetch. Next, we have our trigger type, which can be polling or listener. For polling, we have a configurable scheduler. Our trigger condition defines what would be the data of interest for the integration, and it's fully customizable based on dynamic selections. Our field mapping defines how the data that we collected will be reported to our destination system. It uses dynamic suggestions for each field that we want to add. On the right side, we have the values that are coming as variables from the source system, or there can be hard-coded values based on certain conditions. Now that we have verified our integration, let's go in Azure DevOps and create a new issue. Once the issue is created, it would take a couple of seconds for ZigiOps to pick up the new entity and create the incident in ServiceNow. Then the newly created incident number will be reported back to Azure DevOps. Now, if we go to ServiceNow and look for this incident, we will find it there. It is reported with our short description, and the correlation ID is holding the system ID taken from Azure DevOps. After the initial transfer is completed, we can make updates from both systems. Let's start by creating an update from ServiceNow and then change our state to in progress. Change our description and data comment. Once the incident is saved, we can return to Azure DevOps and we can see our updated record. Our state and description are changed, and our comment has arrived. We can do the same thing the other way around by adding, for example, a comment in Azure, change the description and the state. Once the record is saved, we go back to ServiceNow and check the results. We can see that our state has arrived, the description has changed, and the comment is also here. For more information, please request a demo from our website. Thank you for watching.